I would love to add myself to the mix. Just wanted to see where you're at.
Week 2 of The Bachelor brought a bad bitch contest with the Bachelor baddies from the past, a one-on-one date for Christina Mandrell, and was Brianna spiraling out of control? Hey guys, and welcome to Shared News. I am your host, Zachary Reality, here with my girl, Kayla T. We're gonna dive all into Bachelor Nation and what happened episode 2 tonight. But before we do that, you guys know the drill. Give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you're new here. Kayla, what did you think of this episode? I want to hear your thoughts and then I'll give you mine.
Hi, Zach. What a night. I have to say, okay, I'm mulling it over. I don't know if I was feeling this week's episode. For some reason, I was like bored and I'm trying to process why I was bored because it's the first week of dates. So I'm like, I was so excited going into it. Can't wait to see more of the girls. And we did get that, but maybe I'm thinking it's Zach. Like, Zach felt tired to me. I don't know. How do you feel?
You know what? I was, like, kind of into it, which I feel like is something that no one would expect me to say out of all people, like, yeah, about this season. Exactly. But the reason why is because of Twitter. Like, I spend half of my time watching the episode and then the other half on Twitter. And I am having so much fun reading everyone's tweets. You know, people liking mine.
I need to get back on Twitter.
Also, the memes, the funny jokes.
Oh, and my God, I bet.
People on Twitter are, like, they're so funny. Hilarious. It's just like a different sense of humor. So
it is. It's,
honestly,
it's so
I was kind of getting into it. I'm starting to learn a few girls' names, so that's exciting.
Mm-hmm. That's great. Love that for you.
No, yeah, I was kind of into the drama with Brianna and Christina, too, at the end. I was like, all right, like, little something.
Little something. Yeah. No, it started getting interesting. Yeah, for sure.
What did you, let's get right into it. I mean, we can go through each kind of moment on the show. We're going to talk about our top five moments on the show. So I think the first major moment was the group date where they had the bad bitch competition. They brought back Courtney, Victoria, and Tajwan. What did you think of that competition? Are you a bad bitch? Like, where would you survive?
I definitely would say I'm definitely getting into my, like, yeah, I'm that girl era. I don't know if I can say I'm, like, in a bad bitch era. Like, I just don't really feel like that's me personally. But yeah, I loved this day. I felt like it was different, and I felt like bringing Lotto on, this fit perfectly with her and her energy. And I'm glad the show tried something new with bringing someone like her on. And yeah, I mean, I enjoyed most of the girls, you know, little catwalks, but well, let me not say. I enjoyed it, like, a handful of their catwalks. Sometimes it was just super awkward. But in terms of the competition, I guess it wasn't really a competition because no one really, like, won, right? Someone win?
I have no idea.
I don't remember.
I don't know. I think Catherine got the rose on that date. So she technically did win. I was happy to see my girl Courtney Robertson. She is such an icon.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Like, such a moment. She also just announced that she was starting a podcast, Courtney. She's calling it Off Contract.
I love that.
Me too.
I'm obsessed with that. Are you listening?
It's
interesting.
Gonna
listen, huh?
I'm going to listen. I haven't read, you know, it's so embarrassing that I haven't read her book yet because I'm actually her biggest fan literally ever. But it's the reason why I never read her book is because when I was obsessed with her when I was like 15, I was not going to read a book back then. Now I would read a book, but then it became too long where it wasn't relevant anymore. So now I've read like Hannah's book, Rachel's book, Matt's book. But now I feel like it's not too late to read her book. And
she's
like,
back.
She's back. Like, I wish they made her the bachelorette. I wish she crashed the date, but she's married. And same with Victoria.
Well, she's married, yeah. And you know what? Same as Victoria. You know what
I was
going to say? Like,
both dating.
Speaking of Victoria, like, I expected Victoria to be more of, like, giving more, like, Victoria energy on this episode. But it was completely Taj. So that, I was like, here she goes.
Well, I think Victoria was, like, It's not that she was outshined. I think Victoria just like graduated. Like she just gave us the best season of Paradise because of her. Like she made that last season. Like you wanted an ending? That's true. Victoria Fuller. Like she definitely deserves to be there. They all deserve to be there. But Tajwan was the one that made the biggest impression because she was the only one that was single and she shooted her shot with Zach.
I would love to add myself to the mix. Just wanted to see where you're at.
So she crashes the date. I loved her confidence. And you can tell they were all like so, like, not that they were scared of her, but they were just like, nobody wanted to step up to her. And she was just like giving it. And I wish that Zach.
No, she was.
I wish that Zach kept her, but I feel like they couldn't keep her because like none of the girls reacted.
What do you mean none of the girls reacted? Like,
I feel like because nobody engaged with it really. There, like, imagine there was some drama, really? Then it would have been like a storyline. I thought the girls were just like kind of staring at her.
Like they were shook. No, I felt like they were shook. They kept,
but they were scared of her. Like
the fact that all of them wait. First of all, let me take a step back. Hold on, because I need to give myself props a little bit because I called it. I told you guys on Friday. I was like, Taj is going to interrupt the date. She's going to come through the night portion, but she's not going to stay anyway. We move on. The fact that all of them, like a group of them, came to her and was like, so why are you here? I was like, oh, okay. They had a little back and forth. It got tense. And they were like talking about it together in the ITM. Like they were shook. Like if she stays, like I'm concerned. Like what does that mean for Zach? Like I don't know. If Zach kept her around, I mean, I think it would have snowballed. But I kind of felt like Tajwan, I don't know. I mean, it was interesting to watch. It was entertaining. But like, I wish she would have just like, if she was going to do what she did, I wish she didn't like turn it around. Like, well, I felt like none of y'all were his wife. So, I mean,
yeah,
it was just kind of like, girl, it didn't really need all of that. Like you weren't, that's okay, not why you okay. came. Like you wanted back. You know what I mean? It was just like, okay, you're obviously, you're kind of shook too that maybe he won't keep you. That's why you're.
I respect your take for sure. I feel that. I mean, I think I was just like, I'm such a fangirl, like, and I love Tajwan. So, you know, when you like love someone on TV, like they can't do anything wrong. Right.
No. So
I didn't even see it that way at first. But now that you're explaining it, I'm like, yeah, you're right. Now I get why she had to leave.
Yeah. Zach was like, this is probably not going to go well. So.
Gotcha. I was like, I was just happy to see her. And I still want to know what happened with the uncle.
No, it was fun.
Let's talk Christina Mandrell. She is the single mom from Nashville. She's a content creator. I feel like she's been posting a lot of engaging content about the show. She's kind of like a really cool girl. I feel like I like her. She was in Taylor Swift's music video. Like, she's got a lot going on coming into this season. And like, some of the girls already have issues with her just because... So she met Zach's family and she opened up about her daughter. So what did you think of her date and how did you think that combo went?
Yeah, I mean, well, starting off, this is starting to be like a little bit of a staple for the franchise now of like meeting the family before the actual time you're supposed to. So I find it interesting that they keep doing it. I don't know if I like it. It just feels like I don't even know her. It doesn't feel like it has any like stakes to it because it's like, does it really even matter because it's so early? I don't know. It's weird. But I felt like, of course, she was going to do well. She's a mom. So I loved that she took it well. She is surprising me. Like what you said of you liking her. Like she's surprising me of like, oh, okay. But Zach on the night portion really like, I felt like he was real. And I respected his response to her and opening up about her daughter and it being like, scary. I would have. That's real. Like,
I thought he was gonna send her home.
Now, see, I kind of okay. Here's another. I'm having some hot takes tonight. I feel like he should have, because it's only like the fact that he got that emotional over the thought of stepping into that role when he maybe isn't ready says that he's not. So it's like to prolong that is just gonna make it worse. You know what I mean? Like it's inevitable that they're probably gonna break up. Soon. So
well, yeah, I don't think she's gonna like win the show. But I think that maybe he was thinking like, I don't want to keep her too long, you know, away from her daughter or something like that. Like if he's not feeling it, like there definitely is more pressure when you are dating someone who has a kid, because it's like you don't want to waste their time. But also like they kind of signed up for it and were prepared. And it seems like she also has a really good situation with her baby daddy. I know they didn't mention it, but she did post something on social media about it, like that they're cool and they were like all hanging out with his new girlfriend. Nice. It's like her pinned post.
Oh, that's so nice.
Yeah. So
that
she's
so
all
special,
like,
special and rare. That's cool.
So she just like seems like she is ready to meet someone. Like, I feel like she has her whole situation figured out. I think she's really ready for a relationship. So I'm rooting for her.
Yeah.
And I think that she's just the coolest girl there.
Yeah. I mean, I think you're a fan. Wow. No, I think it's just about if that guy is ready. I don't know if Zach is that guy. Mm-hmm. So that's the point of, that I was making. Is just like, Zach, I don't know. Like, might as well have just been like, hey, I'm just not in that place in my life. That would have been fair.
Well, maybe she'll be the bachelorette. But let's talk about a little bit of the drama between her and Brianna at the rose ceremony. I felt like Brianna was, you know, making that something it didn't have to be. And I don't know why Brianna is like self-sabotaging herself, because she came in so confident. She was that girl, the best personality. She got America voted for her. Like, I felt like I had such high hopes for her. And then, like, within an instant, it was like, whoa, she's being insecure. She's being petty. She's exaggerating. She's being dramatic. Like, where is the Brianna that we gave our first impression rose to?
No, for sure. I mean, I think she said it in the episode. She's like, the fact that I haven't gotten a rose from Zach is what's getting to me. Like, yeah, America can give me a rose. That's great. But like, it's not about America. I'm not going to, you know, get engaged to America at the end of this. This is like Zach's season. So, and I think that Brianna maybe was feeling what Zach was feeling and the disconnect in their one-on-ones. Like, and so that wasn't helping. And the other girls, maybe the tension of her having a rose. So I can understand her spiraling. I wish she didn't, but I agree. You know, I was surprised that, you know, she was kind of making the Christina comment bigger than it was. I was expecting her to say that there was more that we didn't see that Christina did. So
and
I was kind of like, oh, wait,
it.
What happened? But
we
already saw
it.
That. And I was like, okay, I mean, that's a little weak. But yeah, I mean, Christina handled that conversation really well. I was like, wow, maturity.
Yeah.
I mean, she just apologized and...
It felt like an off-camera moment where it was just like really raw. We were able to see the entire interaction, what we think for what it was. And I really think that Christina was being insecure night one, because she also showed up to after the final rose and America voted for Brianna over her. So of course she was a little bit like, oh, Brianna, like, I can't believe it. But like she wasn't trying to be like jealous. She was happy for Brianna.
So.
She was just like a little disappointed because like she wanted it too. And I think that Brianna just like felt that way next week when Christina had the one-on-one day. Christina got the rose and then Brianna was all of a sudden now.
Totally.
You know what I mean? So it was kind of like that. And I actually feel like now that I've like digested this and explained it, like Brianna is still that girl. She just spiraled.
She really is. She just spiraled. And I think this is like, Zach, this is the type of drama that I want to see. Like, it's not overproduced. It was natural. The storyline of, like, Brianna, is she going to get the rose? She's spiraling. Like, we're invested because we voted for her to win the rose.
Yeah.
Like, so we want her to do well, but she's not doing well. It's actually, like, that. And this is when out in the episode when I was like, okay, wait, this is interesting. Like, I'm actually invested here. So it's working well for them, this whole kind of storyline with Brianna and Christina. And
yeah,
the whole thing.
I'm excited for next week. I think we saw in the teaser that Christina might be getting a villain edit, which honestly is great because I already like her. So this will make me like her more. The girls who went home were Victoria, Kat, and Kimberly. Any closing goodbye thoughts, memories, or prayers for them?
Prayers. No, I mean, I'm curious to see like what Christina says next week to really rub like Brooklyn the wrong way. Brooklyn seems like a, hey, I'm just kind of doing my thing, minding my business. But I know that this episode, something that stood out to me that I was like, yeah, this is gonna like snowball into a whole monster that they're not aware of, that they're kind of creating. They're so open with each other about how physical they are with Zach so early. And I don't think I mean, I'm glad they have such great camaraderie with each other, but I don't know if that's going to go over well. And so someone like Brooklyn saying, I'm just going to start removing myself from these conversations. I don't know. I think we're going to see more of that in the coming weeks of girls being like, okay, so you're saying that to try to intimidate me, or you know what I mean? So that.
For sure. I think a lot of these girls are just, I think they're on the younger side. I think we have a lot of girls in their early 20s. Mm-hmm. In one way, it almost kind of does feel like old school Bachelor again. Because I feel like there might be less stakes now since the show has crashed so much that, like, these girls don't have to prove anything, right? Like, there's no no one thinks anyone's lasting. Like, no one is going to follow anyone on Instagram because that, you know, the show has just really changed the last couple of years where it's like these girls can kind of just be themselves. I almost feel like we're going back in time. Mm-hmm. And I'm kind of like, I know I'm going to get into this season. I promise. But I, like, and I'm getting there. But I think it's just getting started. There. And I don't know spoilers for the first time in like four seasons. So that's kind of where I want to end it for me tonight. That's my closing out thoughts.
Yeah.
What about you?
Love it. Love that for you. No, my closing out thoughts are, I think we're on the same page of like, okay, warming up to the season, but I need to see more. And I need Zach to like give me more energy next week. Like, I feel like I'm like,
he needs to take a nap.
He needs some coffee. He needs some like a meal. I don't know what was going on with him, but he was like sleep to me. I was like, okay, Zach.
No, Kayla, for real. I did not even realize he was on the episode. I did not know he was there.
Exactly. You forgot he was there.
Wow. They really did. No, I swear to God. Zachary. And we'll have to talk about Gabby, you know, in another video. Kayla, we have to talk a little bit about the preview for next week, too. I'm going to show you this clip. It looks really crazy, and I need your reaction.
Okay. Oh, gosh.
To spend the night here with me.
I like where I think this is heading. Definitely looks like a walk of shame.
Okay, tell me what you think.
So first of all, Katie having an overnight week two is crazy. Like that, I'm like, okay, so many questions. Did they sleep together? Was it just strictly a sleepover? Like I doubt that nothing happened. Like, I don't know. I'm just like, and the girls responding to her walking in, like, it's kind of walk of shame moment. Like, that is going to stir the pot. And that's what I mean of like all of them sharing all this stuff, a tongue kissing and all this. It's not going to be cute next week, though.
Yeah. This is definitely going to be a twist and a turn. Do not know what to expect. Oh, yeah. Will she take the overnight date? We don't know. You guys definitely let us know what you think in the comments down below. And thank you all so much for joining us tonight. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and ring the bell so you're always updated on all things Bachelor Nation. I'm your host, Zachary Reality with Kayla T. Our socials are on the screen right now, so be sure to give us follows, come say hello, and we'll see you in the next one.